Hi guys, today in this video I'm going to show you how to create an intro similar to the title sequence used in the Breaking Bad. Create a new composition and select the 1080p preset with 24 frames per second. Set the duration to 18 seconds and the background color to black. I provided a periodic table, all its elements and the smoke footage so you can follow along. The download link is located in the video description. Import two elements. I'll use bromine and barium. Put the elements on the timeline and move them wherever you want. Select the type tool and choose a font. I'm using Heartbreaking Bad. If you'd like to use it, the download link is located in the video description. For this font, I'll make the size 250 points. Set the color to white and type out the rest of your text. Import the periodic table and put it on the timeline. Duplicate it by hitting Ctrl D or Command D if you're on a Mac. I'll rename the first periodic table to Table Bromine and the second to Table Barium. Align the periodic tables to the elements. Right-click on the tables and set the blending mode to screen. Go to Layer, New, Null Object. Allow the layers to be manipulated in 3 dimensions. Select the null object, press P on your keyboard, and click on the stopwatch to create a keyframe. Set the value of the z-axis to -2500. Go to 8 seconds and set the value of the z-axis to 2500. Go to Layer, New, Camera, and create a 35mm camera. Open up the camera options and set the depth of field on, the aperture to 50 pixels, and the blur levels to 300%. Go to the start of the clip, select the first table, press P on your keyboard, and set the value of the z-axis to -2500. Do the same thing for the second table, but this time set the value to -3100. Parent the tables to the null object by dragging the pick whip tool. Duplicate the elements by hitting Ctrl D or Command D if you're on a Mac. Select the second bromine layer, press P on your keyboard, and set the value of the z-axis to -2500. Do the same thing for the second barium layer, but this time set the value to -3100. Parent the second bromine layer to the table bromine, and the second barium layer to the table barium. Go to 4 seconds, select the first bromine layer, press T on your keyboard, and click on the stopwatch to create a keyframe. Do the same for the second bromine layer, and set the opacity to 0%. Go to the previous frame, and set the opacity of the second layer to 100%, and the opacity of the first layer to 0%. Go to 3 seconds and set the opacity of the second layer to 0%. Go to 5 seconds and repeat the exact same steps for the barium layers. Select all the element layers by holding down the Shift key and set the blending mode to lighten. Go to 4 seconds, select the first table, press T on your keyboard, and click on the stopwatch to create a keyframe. Reduce the opacity to 0% after 2 seconds to make it disappear. Go to 5 seconds and do the same for the second table. We'll make the text layers appear at 6 seconds. So press T on your keyboard, set the opacity to 0%, and click on the stopwatch to create a keyframe. After a few frames, set the opacity to 100%. Go to Layer, New, Solid. Click on Make Comb Size and create a black solid. Drag the layer below the periodic tables. Go to Effects and Presets and type in Ramp. Drag and drop the effect to the black solid. Put the first slider to the bottom left corner and the second to the top right. Click on the start color and set the red to 10, the green to 40, and the blue to 5. Click on the end color and set the red to 80, the green to 80, and the blue to 5. Create another black solid and drag it below the periodic tables. Go to Rectangle tool, hold your left mouse button, and select the Ellipse tool. Create some masks. Thank you. Open up the masks and increase the mask feather. Create another black solid and drag it below the periodic tables. Go to Effects and Presets and type in Turbulent Noise. Drag and drop the effect to the black solid. Set the blending mode to overlay. Press T on your keyboard and set the opacity to 40%. Create another black solid and drag it below the periodic tables. Press T on your keyboard and create keyframes for the opacity to make the background appear gradually from black and disappear at the end of the clip. Import the smoke footage and put it on the timeline. Drag it at 8 seconds. Go to Effects and Presets and type in Tint. Drag and drop the effect to the smoke footage. Click on the white color and set the red to 100, the green to 100, and the blue to 10. Right-click on the smoke footage and set the blending mode to screen. Go to 11 seconds, select the pen tool and create a mask for each text and element layer. Open up the mask. Click on the stopwatch next to the mask path to create a keyframe and set the mask feather to 50. Play through the footage and modify frame by frame the shape of the mask depending on the motion of the smoke. Repeat the exact same steps for each text and element layer. Thank you. To create the credits at the end of the clip, repeat the exact same steps by moving backwards on the timeline in order to make the text appear behind the smoke. Alright guys, thank you for watching and see you in the next tutorial.